Good morning, students. You have to take out your History and Civics book, Class 7. We have started with the lesson number 1 of Civics, the Constitution of India. The topics we have discussed in this lesson are its introduction, number 2, meaning of Constitution, number 3, making of our Constitution, number 4, the role of Constituent Assembly, number 5, framing of the constitution, number 6, adoption of the constitution, number 7, the preamble to the constitution, number 8, basic elements of the preamble, number 9, objectives of the constitution. Today we will start objectives of the constitution. What do you mean by the word objectives? Goals. It means goals of the constitution. Today we will start goals. The goal of the constitution is to provide justice to all the citizens of India, to provide freedom to all the citizens of India, to provide equal status to all the citizens of India. Let's start with the justice. The preamble declares justice to all the citizens of the India. It is a very wide concept of justice. It includes social justice, economic justice, political justice. According to the constitution, Article 38 declares the social justice to the people. It says that all the citizens should be treated equally, irrespective of their birth, caste, color, religion. The Article 39A of constitution declares the economic justice. It implies that the effort should be made to bridge the gap between the rich and the poor. Article 16 of Constitution states the political justice to all the citizens. It states that all the citizens have the right to participate in the political process of the country. Students, you have to come to the page number 130. Objectives of the constitution. Objective means goal. Justice means to be fair. The preamble assures justice to all the citizens. Assures means declares. It declares justice to all the citizens. It is the quality of being fair and reasonable. The comprehensive concept of justice comprises social justice, economic justice, and the political justice without any discrimination. Comprehensive means wide-ranging. The wide concept of justice includes social justice, economic justice, and the political justice. Social justice. Social justice strongly suggests that all the citizens should be treated equally, irrespective of their birth, caste, race, color, religion, sex, etc. Article 38 says that the state shall strive to promote the welfare of the people. Strive means to try hard. It means the state shall try hard to promote the welfare of the people. Now comes economic justice. It implies that the efforts should be made to bridge the gap between the rich and the poor. Article 39A directs that the state should try to secure that all the citizens have the right to an adequate means of livelihood. Political justice. It means that all the citizens should have the right to participate in the political process equally, irrespective of their race, caste, creed, religion, or birth of a place. Jawaharlal Nehru and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar clearly opined that political justice was meaningless without the economic justice. Liberty. Liberty means freedom. Freedom. The Constitution of India provides right of freedom to the citizens of India. The freedom of speech, the freedom of expression, the freedom to choose any occupation, freedom to adopt any religion, freedom to worship any religion, freedom to reside in any part of the country, freedom to move freely throughout the territories of the India. Let's read. The concept of liberty implies that each individual has the right to liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship. They can think, they can express, they can believe, and they can faith, and they can worship any religion. Article 19 guarantees that all citizens shall have the right to freedom of speech and expression. Right to freedom to assemble peacefully and without arms. It means they can make their groups, but peacefully, without weapons. Form the associations or unions. They can move freely throughout the territory of India. The Indians can reside and settle in any part of the territory of the India. Which article shows the right to freedom? Article 19 of the Constitution shows the right to freedom. And which rights we have got, or which freedoms we have got? Freedom of speech. We can speak in the social medias. We can express our views and opinions. We can group peacefully without the weapons. We can move freely throughout the country. We can reside and settle in any part of the country. Equality. The preamble provides for the equality of status and opportunities. Opportunities means choices. All the citizens are equal before the law and enjoy equal protections of the laws. There is no discrimination between the person on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or the place of birth. All citizens equally enjoy the right to vote and participate in the process of governance. Article 14 to 19 gives the concrete substance and shape to the concept of equality. However, equality does not mean that all persons are equal in all circumstances. Which article provides right to equality? Article 14 to 19. You have to mark it. Concrete means real. These articles shows the real substance and the shape to the concept of equality. Which equalities we have got? And there is no discrimination between the person on the basis of religion. Suppose if anyone wants to take the admission in the school on the basis of the religion, if any school says no to that child, that can be go to the court, and so on. Fraternity. It means spirit of brotherhood. Fraternity implies a spirit of unity and brotherhood. We all are the citizens of India and belong to one Indian family, regardless of religion, language, or regional diversity. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar said, fraternity means a sense of common brotherhood of all Indians, of India, of Indians being one people. It is a principle which gives the unity and solidarity to the social life, solidarity, mutual support. Article 51E says that it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to promote harmony, to promote good mutual relationships and spirit of common brotherhood among all the people of India. Which article of the Constitution provides the fraternity? Article 51E. What it implies? It implies it is a duty of each citizen of India to promote the good relationship and spirit of common brotherhood among the people of India. Dignity of the individual. Dignity means a sign of respect. To take care of the dignity of each individual in our country. The preamble seeks to protect the dignity of the individual. It means that all the citizens are provided with the adequate means of livelihood, just and humane conditions of work, and a decent standard of life. Humane means feeling of sympathy, that citizens should be provided the adequate means of livelihood for earning, and the just and the humane conditions for the working, and the decent standard of life. Article 17 clearly says that untouchability is abolished. Abolished means put to an end, and its practice is in any form is forbidden. Forbidden means not allowed. Unity and integrity of the nation. Integrity means moral and the ethical principles. India is a land of diverse communities, diverse, various. Only through a spirit of common brotherhood and fraternity we can build and sustain national unity. Article 51C says that it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to uphold, means to protect, and to support and to protect the sovereignty, unity and integrity of India. Article 51, again, Article 51C of Constitution says that it is the duty of every citizen of India to support and to protect sovereignty, unity and integrity of India. Now come to Do You Know? Do you know Samvidhan Divas, that is Constitution Day, is celebrated on 26th November every year? On 26th November 1949, the Constituent Assembly of India adopted Constitution of India. The term federal or federation has not been used in the text of Constitution. Federalism means it can be said as the form of government in which there is a division of power between two levels of government of equal status, that is central government and the state government. In our country, in our constitution, there is a division of power between the state and the union, but there is no division of sovereignty. Students, today we have completed our lesson number 1 of civics, Constitution of India. I hope you have also completed your exercises side by side. Thank you.